Hello, this is John Erickson from the Planetarium at the Lawrence Hall of Science, and it looks a little bit like I'm out in a valley in Yellowstone Park after sunset, but really, like a lot of us, I'm working from home. And today, we're going to have a conversation about satellites. Now, usually I talk about things that you can see in the sky, like the sun and the moon, stars. Can you see satellites? When I go outside just for fun to look at the night sky or to see what I want to talk about with you, I usually see a satellite. If I'm very careful and look for a while, I might see two or even more satellites. So yes, you can see satellites. So what are you looking for when you're trying to see a satellite in the night sky? Well, if it's a clear night, you might see some of the brighter stars, and then you might see one star. It might be bright, it'll probably be very faint looking, moving slowly along, maybe a little slower than you'd expect to see an airplane appear to move. It won't be blinking at all, and it won't make any noise. If you see that, you're probably looking at a satellite. I said that the satellites we see appear to move a little slower than you'd expect an airplane to move. Well, the satellites we see are much farther away than any airplane we're looking at, and they're moving much faster. It takes a satellite like the ones that we can see in the sky about an hour and a half to go all the way around the Earth. These videos are taken from a satellite, a special one that I'll mention a little later. And they show how quickly satellites cover ground as they orbit the Earth. Satellites can be nearer Earth or farther away. The farthest satellites are too faint and far away to see from Earth. The ones that we might see in the night sky are satellites that are in low Earth orbit, usually about 200 to 300 miles above the surface of the Earth. And I'm back in the valley in Yellowstone Park, just a little bit after sunset, maybe a few minutes ago. I can imagine that the sun set in front of me, and then looking behind me, I can imagine I still see a mountain with the sun shining on its peak. And the sun is shining on the mountain peak and not at me, because I'm down low, and the mountain peak is up high. Probably in a few minutes, the Earth will have turned a little bit more, and that mountain would have moved into the darkness and it would be night all around me. But the tall mountain, for several more minutes, I will see lit by the sun. If it were taller, I would see it lit up longer. Well, what's really high up there that might stay lit up by the sun an hour, 2 hours, even a little bit more after the sun goes down? Satellites. Here we see a diagram and it shows Earth. It shows a place on Earth where there's a person looking up into the sky, and it shows the orbit of a satellite. The satellite is in low Earth orbit. What's not showing is far away, the sun. Light from the sun is streaming toward Earth, and that's what gives Earth its daytime side, and the side that's not facing the sun is the Earth's nighttime side. A person in the on the Earth, looking up, she or he is on the nighttime side. Above that person's head is the satellite, but the satellite is high enough so that the sun is shining on the satellite, and that person, if that person is paying attention, might be able to look up and see that satellite. Since the satellite is moving, it will be going around, and it eventually is going to go on to the dark side. If the person is still looking at the satellite, that person might see the satellite turn from a little bright speck to a speck that can't be seen at all. The biggest satellite that I know is the International Space Station. And since it's big, it looks very bright, like a bright spot in the sky, not just a faint one. You may have seen it crossing the sky and thought, oh, there's the light of an airplane. What makes the International Space Station special is that there are people living on board. When you watch the International Space Station cross the sky, you may see it go from a part of the sky where the sun shines on it into a part of the sky where it's in the shadow of the Earth. To you, it looks like the little spot is fading, but at the same time, people on the space station, if they're looking out the window, we'll see the sunset. For those of you who are watching for the International Space Station this weekend,
wait, that's a video of me about to tell you how you can see the International Space Station in early April, but that's already happened. Let's see what we saw. Here's a video I made with my phone from the sidewalk outside the place I live, and I can see a bright spot here, that's the planet Venus, and a fainter spot here. It looks bright to me, but it looks pretty small right now, and that is the International Space Station as it passed overhead on April 6th, 2020.
So as always, I hope you get a chance to look up. The sky is there. The sky doesn't cost anything. Find someone in your household, dress warmly, and go out to the yard or the sidewalk and look up, see what you can see. And I hope I get to see you sometime soon at the Lawrence Hall of Science.